Hello there and welcome to Buckeye Bright Spot. I'm your host, Tim McMahon. This show is dedicated to those organizations and individuals that are making a difference every day in Toledo and the surrounding region. Thanks for joining me today. We have a great show as usual. Our first story takes us downtown to One Seagate to check out the Prism Creative Community Art Show. This exhibit was one of a kind and did not disappoint.
Hi, I'm Annette Jensen, and I'm very pleased to be with you today and to talk about the exhibition going on down at One Seagate. It's called Breaking Ground, A Retrospective Progress. It's a historic exhibit spanning the last 150 years of art in Northwest Ohio. So it's really an exciting opportunity. Prism Creative Community has been around for almost 12 years now. We originally started in about 2005, 2006, a group of educators and people who wanted to have more cultural opportunities in the community. It was fashioned not to replace any other institution or programs, but actually to complement and to bring new programming to the community that did not exist. And so we provided education and new collaborative and volunteer opportunities to bring culture treasures to the community. We do have a program in which local artists are able to bring their work out into the community and have it viewed or shown. We curate art in public places. So, for example, Sambi's Restaurant in Bowling Green is a place that we have curated art for maybe the last 6 or 7 years. And every 4 months we switch it out into a completely new collection, and people are able to see and appreciate people who do pottery, glass, ceramics, jewelry, and all kinds of two-dimensional artwork. And it gives a little economic stimulus to the community as well. Gives people an opportunity to sell their work and for the community to appreciate it. We all love to live in a community where there's cultural enrichment, where we can enjoy the beauty and the relaxation of the creative act. So many people get therapy just by making something. And the Prism is different in that it also supports the local hobbyist, or as well as the professional. So anyone who likes to do visual art or literary arts can be involved in the Prism program. And it's over the years brought a lot of education to the community. We do workshops in creative writing as well as all kinds of visual art medias. So we do what we can to enrich the community. And we ask, you know, community members, if they really want these opportunities, they need to look at where their tax dollars are going, where their contributions and donations are going. Are they paying for salaries? Are they paying for actual programs? What is your money going toward? And we're very proud that even though we are kind of a low budget organization, as like a new business would be, we have been able to contribute very vital resources to the community through collaborating with other organizations and coordinating a lot of different volunteers. When you look at the legacy that we've been given, the original founders of this community were very vested in culture, education, and the arts. They left us a legacy of which we should be very proud. This, you might say they were breaking ground. They established the Toledo Museum of Art. They established great educational institutions. And the goal was always to support our local people in their education and their advancement into the professional world. And we still want to continue that legacy. So the title Breaking Ground would suggest that we are still making an effort 150 years later or so. The second part, or the byline of the title, A Retrospect of Progress, means this exhibition looks at where are we today, 150, 160 years later. Are we still breaking ground? And I think when you see the exhibit, you'll say, yes, we are, because the exhibit features, number one, it celebrates the cultural, not only the cultural legacy that we have through many historical artists over the last 150 years, but it highlights the new emerging artists that are brand new among us, that are trying to get their resumes built up and their success going. And that it also celebrates our local artists that are among us, that are very successful, that people don't even know about. So there's three different distinct groups represented in the exhibition, past, present, and future. This piece right behind me here is by Bob Mazur. Bob was a very loved professor at BGSU. This is one of the last original artworks that he produced, and it is being sold. In fact, it just sold, but it's going toward supporting a scholarship program at BGSU for a deserving student who will study the arts. We have Emmanuel Enriquez, who was voted as the People's Choice Award for the professional section, and most people will know him by the bronze sculpture that he did for the fifth third field at the little children peeking through the fence at the baseball game. But they don't know that he is also a very accomplished oil painter. So this beautiful portrait over here is of his niece and just a spectacular, very popular specimen in the exhibit. Another thing I'm really excited about is we're showcasing the work of Edith Franklin. Edith was a potter in our area, who was one of the original founders of the Toledo Potter Guild. She also attended the first glass workshop at the Toledo Museum of Art and studied a little bit under Dominic Labino and Harvey Littleton and kind of mixed it up with these original pioneers of the studio glass movement. But there are several pieces here that are very historic. One of them is a ceramic mug that she made for Mrs. Stranahan on her 90th birthday. And Edith became the first director of the 577 Foundation in Perrysburg, the ceramics director. She became the first director. So there's on the table at the back of the exhibition where there's a lot of 3D work, you can see great big, huge pieces of pottery, one of which used to be used as a punch bowl for art receptions. So it's really kind of fun. There's also the original founders of the Sculpture Guild here. So you see work by Pat Wagaman and Joanne Cousineau and Darlene Crone and James Havens, who is runs the foundry in Gibsonburg for pouring brass things. So those people, some of them are still with us and some of them have just recently passed away. And there's a lot of history of glass in the exhibit, which is really exciting because we call Toledo the Glass City. We're really excited about our history and legacy in this area. Three of the people who were at the original Toledo Museum of Art studio glass class that was held out in the garage of the museum, three of the original people in that class that started the studio glass movement are represented here in the exhibition. There's Dominic Labino, who was, you might say he was a chemist with glass. He figured out how to make a kiln, a glass kiln, that could fire at a lower temperature. It was like an invention of the time, which allowed people for the first time to make glass in a private studio. And then also, if you look, we have several very accomplished glass artists that are in the exhibition that are the pride of Toledo. One of them is Jack Schmidt, who made this beautiful sculpture here in front of us. And he owns a studio right here in downtown Toledo with his wife, Shawn Messenger. And she has her own technique, and her beautiful work is in the 3D showcases on the river down there. It's just an exciting collection that you'll, over 300 pieces showing the history of art in the last 150, 160 years in Toledo. I'd like to add a plea for the public to those people who love culture and who love having these opportunities as part of the enrichment of our community. We need your support. We need you to know where your donations are going, where your tax dollars are going. And as our federal government and our state and local governments change over time and programs change, it's up to us as individuals to support the causes that we believe in. And when you look at the history of civilizations, what is it that endures after we are gone? It's the things that we created. They are the things that tell of our history and our legacy. So I hope that you will support local artists, that you will encourage people, that you will support the nonprofit work of people like PRISM Creative Community, so these opportunities will not cease to exist.